A very good morning to all the students of class 12 political science, and welcome back to the online classes here. Students, we had already started our first chapter of our second book, that is Politics in India Since Independence, and we had finished two parts of this particular chapter, and today we are going to start the third part, that is the consequences of the partition. But before I start this particular topic, I would like to revise what all the topics we have already covered, because those two parts, part number one and especially part number two, which we have covered in the last video, that is very much relevant to the third video, which I am going to start today, that is challenges of or consequences of partition. So basically, I told you there were three basic important challenges which immediately came in front of India as the newly independent country, and I told you that was related to the unity or a nation building was the first, second was establishing democracy, and the third one was ensuring development and well-being of all. But I also told you in this first particular chapter, we will be taking only shape a nation that will be united about the unity and nation building. Okay, so I told you in this particular, in relation to the first chapter, that is nation building, this is the first challenge our nation immediately faced after the independence. And under this topic, nation building, I told you we will study about partition, merger of princely states and reorganization of states. So in the second video, that's part two of this particular chapter, I had started the topic partition, and in detail I had explained you about this topic, partition, displacement and rehabilitation. In this I told you also about the two nation theory. So in detail we had done this particular topic, and later in this second part we did a topic, that is process of partition, which is a very important topic, because before reading what were the consequences of partition, it was very important for us to know what was the process of partition. So in studying and understanding this concept of process of partition, I told you the basic principle which was followed for the partition of India and Pakistan was the principle of religious majority. So on this particular principle, the partition of India was held. So it looked so easy that we can divide the country into two parts with the religious majority, but this has put up various difficulties and challenges in front of India as well as Pakistan. So I had discussed four major problems and difficulties which India has faced in the process of partition. Okay, so we had taken these problems one by one, and we had discussed all the four problems already. So moving forward, after the process of partition, the next topic which is coming up is consequence of partition, and this is one of the most important topic. You will get direct questions from this topic, that in 6 marks also and 4 marks also, that what were the consequences of partition of India. So you have to write the important consequences, but in this we will try and understand and cover all the important points related to consequences of partition. So it's written here, the year 1947 was the year of one of the largest, most abrupt, unplanned and tragic transfer of population that human history has known. So this was the most, we will say, this was unplanned and tragic transfer of people from one place to another, or from this border to that border, and this was unplanned. No one has ever thought this is going to be so destructive, there would be so much of killings and atrocities and communal rights. So there was, this all was unexpected and uncontrollable at a certain period of time. So that is why it is called as the most tragic transfer of the population that human history has known. It is compared to as a human history, such an event has taken place. Okay, there were killings, atrocities on both sides of the border. If you talk about the division of India as Pakistan and India, on the both sides of the borders there were a lot of killings and atrocities in the name of religion. People of one community were ruthlessly killing and aimed people of the other community. People of one community, that the Hindus or Sikhs, were killing the other member of the communities, that is Muslims, and in the same way Muslims were killing the community or the people of the Hindus or Sikhs. So this was all because consequence of the partition. So as I told you, this was not an easy task, as we said that on the basis of principle of majority of religion we can divide India and Pakistan, but there were lot of challenges that India had faced, as we had already read the four problems which came after in the process of partition. So these were the outcomes and consequences of those problems. Here people are fighting amongst themselves. Cities like Lahore, Amritsar and Kolkata. Lahore, Amritsar and Kolkata, cities like this became divided into communal zones. These important cities during the partition became the communal zones, and these communal zones means a zone where there was the concentration of a single community. For example, Muslims would avoid going into an area where mainly Hindus or Sikhs lived. So Muslims always avoided going to the places where Hindus and Sikhs lived. In the same way, Hindus and Sikhs stayed away from the areas where Muslims were predominant and majority in number. Forced to abandon their house and move across borders, people went through immense suffering. So many of the people were forced, we can say, as there was a partition. So Muslims had to go towards Pakistan, and the Hindus living in the areas or the territory of Pakistan, Sikh as well as Hindus, had to move towards India. So this has put immense problems and sufferings for the people migrating from their original homes. Minorities on the other side of the borders fled their homes and often secured temporary shelters in refugee camps. Many people left their homes and they stayed in the refugee camps. They often found unhelpful local administration and police in what was till recently their own country. So the police and administration which was there in their own country, suddenly they were alien in their own homes and they were not getting the support and help from the administration as well as police in their own country. Now they traveled to the other side of the new border by all sorts, so they were not getting any support. So as they were Muslims, so they wanted to go to Pakistan. In the same way, people living in the territory of Pakistan who were Hindus and in minorities moved anyhow towards Indian borders. So in this, they traveled on the other side on the border by all means on foot. They started walking on foot. Even during this journey, they were attacked. While walking also, they were attacked and killed and raped. Here we will talk when this situation partition was going on. There was so much of chaos in the country across the borders. People were moving from one place to other to be safe and secure. As partition had taken place on the basis of religion, that is Hindu and Muslim, and Pakistan was a separate state for the Muslims here. So we could see that women were the mostly target and who have suffered a lot during this partition. Thousands of women were abducted on both sides of the border, not only Hindus, Muslims, but Hindus also. Both sides of the women faced a lot of problems. They were made to convert to religion. When they were caught there, they were forcefully forced to convert their religion, and they were also forced to marriage. In many cases, women were killed by their own family. So the many family members who didn't wanted the women of their family to be abducted and forced to get married and converted their religion, in that case many family members by they themselves killed the females of their family to preserve the family honor and respect. And also many children were separated from their parents. Those who managed to cross the border found that they had no home. Children and parents were separated. There was so much of rush, running, killings. So parents and children were separated, and all those children and parents who managed to cross the border, they found themselves having no home. For lakhs of these refugees, the country's freedom meant life in refugee camp. So after freedom and independence, where people were very happy, but because of this partition, many for many people the freedom was just their life in a refugee camp. This is a very famous phrase as well, that for many refugees, country's freedom meant life in the refugee camp for months and sometimes for years. For months and years, people stayed in the refugee camps as they were not having any allotted homes or property, since they had to leave their country. Now talking about the partition further. Writers, poets and filmmakers. As a child, now also we have seen many movies, you have read many storybooks, many novels, you have seen many dramas. So all this, the story of the partition and the consequences and imbalance during the this situation of partition, many filmmakers and novels and have been depicted, the life of the people has been depicted through filmmakers in the different movies as well as documentary movies as well as novels. That's why it's written, writers, poets and filmmakers in India and Pakistan have expressed the ruthlessness of the killings and the sufferings of the displacement. Through their movies, novels, stories and poems, they have shown the killings and suffering and displacement and violence in the novels, short stories, poems and films. While recounting the trauma of the partition, they have also used the phrase that the survivors. In these stories and movies, they have also said the people who are the survivors after the partition, they themselves said an important phrase that is survivor. They have described partition. The people who have survived after the partition, they said, a division of hearts. This was not a partition of a country or the people from one country to another, or the physical division of a country or on the basis of religion, but it was a division of the hearts. This was a phrase given by the survivors themselves who have faced this trauma of partition themselves. So moving forward now, the partition was not merely a division of properties, liabilities. It means this partition was not only the physical division of the land or property or liabilities and assets, or political division of the country. Political division means one part was Pakistan, which was consisting of the community of the Muslim, and other was the Hindus and Sikhs and other minority communities. But the administrative apparatus, what also got the things which also got divided with the partition, with the process of partition, was what also got divided were the financial assets also got divided, and things like tables, chair. Can you imagine even tables, chairs, typewriters in the offices, paper clips, books, all the musical instruments of the police bands, employees, even the employees of the government, and even the railways were also divided. So this was the extreme condition of the division, where not only people and physical land was divided on the basis of the community, but also table, chair, typewriter, paper clips, books, also musical instrument of the police band, government employees and railways also got divided equally among both the communities. Above all, it was a violent separation of communities, but we would not say that it was a peaceful separation or the partition of India into India and Pakistan. This was a violent separation, as we have seen, and it was unplanned. No one had ever thought that the condition would be going so harsh and it would be unable to control them. Communities who had hitherto lived together in a neighborhood, it is estimated that partition forced around 80 lakh people to migrate across the new border. Around 80 lakh people went across the border from India to Pakistan. But on the other hand, there was so much of violence and communal rights during this partition and the process of partition. Around, it is said, 5 to 10 lakh people have been killed in the partition related to violence. In this violence of communal rights between the people and which the problems in the process of partition, which was not easy as we thought, around 5 to 10 lakh people were killed. And the next problem coming up was that beyond the administrative concern, the financial strains, however, the partition posed another deeper issue. Now the partition has another issue and deeper issue. The leaders of Indian nationalist struggle did not believe in two nations. As we know, during the freedom struggle, our Congress and all the national struggles, they were not in favor of the two nation theory. But with the intervention of the British rule, British India or Britishers, before they handed over the power to Indian Union, they had managed to separate India into two parts and made partition of or a separate country for Muslims, that is Pakistan. But and yet partition on religion basis had taken place. Although the national freedom fighters and strugglers did not want it, and they did not believe on two nation theory, but after that, yet partition on religious basis had taken place, okay, because this partition was on the basis of religion. Did that make India as a Hindu nation? Did that now mean that since we have given a separate country to the Muslims in India, does that mean that the now remaining part in India was a Hindu nation automatically? This is a question to you. Even after large-scale migration of Muslims to the newly created Pakistan, now as I told you, around 80 lakh people or Muslims have migrated across the border already. The Muslims from India has gone to Pakistan. But after that also, around 20% of the Muslims were still living in India. This is the survey of 1991. That is 20% of the total population. 12% of the total population of India, 12% was of Muslims. So how would the government of India treat its Muslim citizens. So how we were going to treat our Muslim citizens who stayed back in India, as there was no such provisions that no Muslims will stay in India after partition. They had the right, if they wanted to stay in India, they could stay. So what would the treatment Indian government would do for these people? And other also, not only Muslims, and also other religious minorities like Sikh, Christians, Jains, Buddhists, priests and Jews. The partition had already created severe conflicts between two communities. So what was could be the future of the other religious minorities, including Muslims, Jains, Buddhists, Christians and Sikhs? Because this was not said that it is a Hindu nation, as we followed the secularism. There were competing political interests behind these conflicts. The conflicts which were going on the basis of religion and partition. The Muslim League was formed to protect the interest of Muslims. We very well know before the independence, this Muslim League was formed to protect the interest of the Muslims in colonial India, because they thought that Indian Congress did not pay attention to the minorities of Muslims. It was in the forefront of the demand for the separate Muslim nation. So that is why this Muslim League has demanded a separate nation, that is Pakistan. Similarly, there were organizations which were trying to organize Hindu. On the other hand, there were also some organizations and groups which were organizing or trying to organize Hindus in order to turn India into a Hindu nation. There were some organizations who wanted India to be a only Hindu nations. No other minorities like Sikh, Christian, Muslim, Jains, Buddhist should be allowed to stay in India. But most leaders of the national movement, but the important leaders and freedom fighters of the national movement believed that India must treat persons of all religions equally. But before independence, as we all had fought the war and struggle for the freedom to get independence from the British rule together, people from all the society and all the communities have come together strongly together and united so strong that we got the independence. So the freedom struggles and fighters had already decided that our country would be a secular country where all the religions would be given equal status and no single religion would be given dominance or importance. Is written here, India should not be a country that gave superior status to adhere to any one faith. That is, India would be a country which will not be give support or dominance to any one faith and treat inferior to the other practice or other religion. It means all citizens would be equal irrespective of their religious affiliation. All citizens will be equal in front of law, in front of constitution, irrespective of their religions which they are following. They were free to follow any religion they would like. This was the idea and plans of the people who fought our freedom struggle. They cherish therefore the idea of secular. That is why the freedom strugglers always thought that we will support the idea of secular nation. This idea was inside in that. That is why this idea has been mentioned in the provision in the Indian constitution, which is a basic structure of our constitution, that we have a secular nation. This topic would also be one of the important element of the consequences of the partition. If we will see what happened after the partition, that is Mahatma Gandhi as the father of the nation, you know, Mahatma Gandhi's sacrifice. What we are studying in this particular block is given the about Mahatma Gandhi. As we know, he was one of the important freedom struggler in the 1947. But after we gained independence, he was not happy at all, because this freedom struggle came with partition, and this Mahatma Gandhi never wanted. He always wanted to unite all the communities of India together. He wanted to unite people. He wanted India to be secular. He wanted people to be to follow non-violence and work with Satyagraha. But he was unable and he failed to unite people. That is why he was very disheartened, and he was not happy at all after freedom. We got independence in 1947. So he was in Kolkata when we got freedom, and Gandhiji was on the pursuit. So he started persuading Hindu and Muslim when there were so much of communal rights going on in our country during the partition. He persuaded Hindus and Muslims who gave up violence. Now the people of Hindu and Muslim gave up violence in Kolkata. That is, his presence in Kolkata greatly improved the situations and destructions going in Kolkata among the communal groups. So after the situations were controlled in Kolkata, he later on moved to the next place, that is Delhi. Now when he went to Delhi, he saw there was a large scale violence going on, and people were killing each other of the one community, that is Hindu was killing, or the Sikh were killing the other community, that is Muslim, and on the other hand Muslims are killing the Hindus and Sikhs. So he was very disheartened to see the here. He wanted to control the situation in Delhi also. He was unhappy with what he saw, the Indian government decision not to honor the financial commitments to Pakistan. There were various commitments made to government of Pakistan which were not fulfilled. He was not happy about it. With all this in mind, he undertook what called out to be his last fast. With all that in mind, he started a last fast in January 1948. As in Kolkata, his fast has a dramatic effect. As with the help of his fast in Kolkata, he was able to influence people not to be violent with each other, and the situations were under control in Kolkata. Same thing he tried and did in Delhi, and things were becoming okay there also. Communal tensions and violence reduced. So in Delhi also, after Gandhiji's entry there and his fast, the violence has reduced in Delhi also. Muslims of Delhi and surrounded area could safely return to their homes. Now people were easily able to return to their homes. Okay, now Gandhiji's actions. Now Gandhiji was trying to unite India and people of different communities of Hindus and Sikh and Muslims and other minority groups. He was trying to unite them, as he always wanted India to be a united country and a country with having so lot of diversity but still having unity. But this action of Gandhiji was not liked by all. There were some Hindu extremists who were following the strict ideology of Hindus. They did not like these ideas of Gandhiji. The communities blamed him too of their condition. He was particularly disliked by those who wanted Hindus to take revenge. So Gandhiji was not liked by mostly the people who wanted Hindus to take revenge or who wanted India to become a country of the Hindus. Such organizations and groups who supported India and wanted India to be a country only for Hindus, just as Pakistan had for Muslims. So in the same way, so when Gandhiji tried to unite people, some people were not happy with him, and there is an incident. They accused Gandhiji of acting interest for Muslims and Pakistan. They said that Gandhiji also acted and supported Muslims and Pakistan. Okay, Gandhiji, though that people were misguided, although Gandhiji knew that those people were misguided. Okay, so all this led to that. Finally, on 30th January 1948, one such extremist, there was someone extremist who did not like the actions and ideas and ideology of Gandhiji, that is Nathuram Vinayak Godse, walked up to Gandhiji during his evening prayer in Delhi and fired 3 bullets at him, killing him instantly. So he was killed by Nathuram Vinayak Godse, who was an extremist. Thus ended the long struggle for truth. With this, the death of Gandhiji, there was an end of long struggle for truth, non-violence, justice and tolerance. As you know, these were the basic ideologies of Gandhiji, that is truth, non-violence, justice and tolerance. So Gandhiji's death led to almost magical effect on the communal situation of the country. So after the death of Gandhiji, there was a magical impact on the situation of the communal situation of the country. Partition related anger and violence suddenly subsided. Everything became cool and calm. Everything stopped. The government of India cracked down. After this killing of Mahatma Gandhi, the government of India cracked down on organizations. So there were some rules and regulations made up for the organizations on both sides, whether Hindus, Muslims or Sikh, for spreading communal hatred. Okay, they were banned. Organizations like Rashtriya Svayamsevak Sangh, RSS, were banned for some time. Communal politics began to lose its appeal. So these were some of the consequences after the partition. So there could be a 6 marks question or a 4 marks question. So you will be having lot of points to write about this particular topic. Okay, read this particular section of your NCERT book properly and point the important points which you can write for the answers. If the question is in relation to the consequences of the partition, and there may be 6 points, 7 points, or 4 or 5 points. Thank you.